Hey everybody, this is Ron with our DIY Homestead, and today we're going to be installing a solar powered drip irrigation system. We're out here by our hydroponic system. We have no running water. That's why we put the hydroponic system out here. We fill it up with a hose and it lasts for a very long time. So we're going to do pretty much the same thing with our drip irrigation. We're not going to be going out of the hydroponics bed, but we have added another tote that's filling up with water right now. This was a 325 gallon tote and I had to cut it down, so we're going to have probably 200 gallons of water in there. Just the reason I cut it down is just so it could fit inside our little hut here. And what we're going to do is install this system. I've got it right here in this box. It has got so many things in it. Solar panel, all the tubing, all the little water spouts that go in each pot. This one's big enough to do 30 pots. And we've got a control system or control unit that we can set how long we want it to run and how often we want it to run. And it's got a water sensor on it, so when the water gets too low, the pump's not going to run and burn up. And it's got a battery inside of it to hold the charge on cloudy days. But let me go over here and I'll show you where I'm going to mount the solar panel itself. I'm going to go right up here on the peak and mount it right up on top. So it's going to get sun probably 80% of the day. Daylight, I should say. But I think that'll be a good spot for it. And then we'll go down inside and we're going to put the control unit right over here, probably hang it right off this pole. It's got to be within 5 feet of the water, so we'll just hang it right there by the wire. So the solar panel will be up on top there. We'll run the wire down the panel or down that bar over to the control unit and have the hose go down into the control unit and then the hose go over to the pots. And it's a little confusing, but we'll get going and let's see what happens. I'll show you each step along the way. All right, we've got our solar panel mounted on top. It's going to get sun, like I said, a good part of the day. And we've also got the control unit mounted. And we're just fixing to test it out to make sure everything's working. I've got the cable running down. You can kind of see it here. Down around. I've got it mounted right here by the tank. I've got a filter in the tank. And I've also got water sensors so it can shut itself off and won't burn a pump up when it gets too low. So let's turn this thing on. Hopefully not drop my phone in the water. Get this filter down in there farther. Hopefully I didn't turn everything off, and I didn't. Hit the wrong button on my phone and it went black. Okay, let's try it out. Let's turn this on. There it is. Not a lot of pressure. Don't need a lot of pressure for a drip irrigation. It'll be enough to flow all the way through the line. So now it's time to hook up the pots. And let's keep going. Let's try this now. All right. We are all set. Ready to start installing all these lines into the pots. And the first thing we're going to do is cut this line coming from the pump going to the first pot, because we're going to be splicing into it and going on down the line. So we'll cut it. I've already got a zip tie here. We're going to slide it through there just to hold it up in place. We don't want it cinched tight. And then they gave you these little handy tees. If you can get the package open, It's the first time setting it up, so bear with me, please. But we'll get it. So I take one of the little T's, push it on, put the line onto the next. No, we don't want to do that yet. We want to get a line going down to the pot, which is right around there. So let's cut. We'll cut that. Then we'll hook this line on to the other side to go to the next pot. And then we'll hook this line on to go down to the plant. And then we'll take one of the downspouts. That's what I'm calling them. I don't know what you want to call them. We'll hook that up. And then we'll push that right down next to the roots. And we'll get going on to the next one. I'll show you everything. I'm not going to put them into the ground yet. I want to run it before just to make sure everything's running to every pot. But we'll go ahead and hook everything up, and I'll show you when we're done. All right, we've got everything hooked up to every pot. I've got it running right now, just testing everything. And as you can see, it's working just fine. I went around to every pot and checked them, and every one of them was dripping. I was a little concerned because this is a long run. This is a 30 pot system. I'm going, is the pump strong enough to get it to the last one? But all the way around, and the very last one is dripping. So I think it's going to work out fantastic. Well, I hope you enjoyed it. Learned a little bit something. If you got any questions, I'd be glad to try to answer them. Just leave them in the comments. And we will see you in the next video.